गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई एम क्षितिज एंड इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डू सम न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम्स बेस्ड ऑन एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ डायमेंशन एनालिसिस। बिफोर वी स्टार्ट, आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू ऑल टू प्लीज ज्वाइन अवर यूट्यूब चैनल एंड क्लिक ऑन द बेल आइकन्स सो यू मे गेट नोटिफाइड रिगार्डिंग अवर फ्यूचर वीडियोज। सो वी विल स्टार्ट विथ 7 dimensions of the world. So as we know, there are 7 fundamental quantities: length, mass, time, temperature, current, amount of substance and luminous intensity. So there will be 7 dimensions for them. For length, dimension is L. For mass, dimension is M. For time, dimension is T. For temperature, dimension is K. For current, dimension is A. For amount of substance, dimension is N. And for luminous intensity, dimension is J. And all the derived quantities are expressed in terms of all these 7 fundamental quantities. So dimensions of the physical quantity, the powers of a fundamental quantity in a derived quantity are called dimensions of that quantity. So where we are going to use the dimensions? We are having 3 major applications of a dimension. First application is to check the correctness of an equation. Okay. Second application is to convert one system of unit into another system of unit. And third application is to derive a formula. So in this video, we are going to study the first application. How to check the correctness of an equation. So how will we check the correctness of an equation? So we will use one principle called as the principle of homogeneity. The principle of homogeneity means whenever we are having an equation, so for an equation to be dimensionally correct, the dimensions of the left hand side of an equation has to be equal to dimensions of the right hand side of the same equation. Okay, so we will do some numerical problems on the basis of principle of homogeneity. Okay, so we will do van der Waal equation on the principle of homogeneity. Like we are having the dimensions of constant, we need to find the dimensions of the constant A and B occurring in van der Waal equation. So van der Waal equation is P plus A by B square into V minus B is equal to RT. P is pressure, A is constant, V is volume, V is another constant, R is gas constant, T is temperature. We need to find the dimensions of A and dimensions of B. So by the principle of homogeneity, we know that we are adding P and A by B square. Two quantities can be added only if they are carrying the same dimensions. So we are having P and we are having A by B square. So by the principle of homogeneity, dimensions of P has to be equal to dimensions of A by B square. P is pressure, A is constant and V is volume. We need to calculate the dimensions of A. So A will be equal to P into V square. P is pressure. Pressure is equal to force by area. Dimension of force is MLT minus 2. And dimension of area is L square. So we will get the dimensions of P, ML minus 1, T minus 2. Okay. Similarly, the dimensions of B, volume. Volume does not matter what type of geometric figure we are having. The dimensions of the volume will always be equal to L cube. So dimensions of A will be equal to dimensions of P into dimensions of B square. Dimensions of P are ML minus 1, T minus 2 and B square dimension is L3 square. So you will get ML 5, T minus 2. Okay, similarly we are subtracting B from V. So the V is volume and B is constant. So dimensions of B will be equal to dimensions of V. V is volume. Okay, so dimensions of B will be equal to L cube. Okay, we will move to our next question. Okay, we need to check the correctness of the physical equation S is equal to ut plus half at square. So S is displacement, u is initial velocity, t is time, a is acceleration. So the for equation to be dimensionally correct, dimensions of the LHS has to be equal to dimensions of RHS. In the LHS, we are having S. So dimensions of S. S is displacement. Displacement is nothing but some sort of shortest distance between two points. So dimensions of S will be L1, M0, T0. Order of M, L, T does not matter. We are writing L1, M0, T0. On the right hand side, we are having UT plus half AT square. So dimensions of U and dimensions of T. U is velocity. Dimensions of velocity is L1, M0, T minus 1. And dimensions of time is L0, M0, T1. And dimensions of A is L1, M0, T minus 2. Dimensions of time is L0, M0, T square. By combining all, we will get dimensions of RHS L1, M0, T0. So we are getting dimensions of LHS is equal to dimensions of RHS. By principle of homogeneity, the given equation S is equal to UT plus half AT square, which is nothing but second equation of motion, is correct. Dimensionally, by principle of homogeneity, second equation of motion is correct. Now we will take another example. We will here use the Laplace formula for speed of sound in a gas. So, okay, the Laplace formula, velocity of sound is given by gamma p by d to power 1 by 2. This velocity of sound wave, gamma is the constant, p is pressure, d is density. So, by squaring on both sides, we will get d square is equal to gamma p by d. We need to find the dimensions of gamma. So, we will rearrange the equation. So, we will get gamma is equal to b square d by p. So, gamma will be equal to b square into d by p. The dimensions of b square, b is lt minus 1 whole square. Dimensions of d are ml minus 3. D is density is equal to mass by volume. So, you will get ml minus 3 t0. And dimensions of pressure, pressure is ml minus 1 t minus 2. You will solve them and rearrange by using the rules of exponent. You will get dimensions of gamma is m0 l0 t0. So gamma is the dimensionless constant. So we are going to study the second application in our next video.